Yesterday, you said I love you for the first time. It was only a dream, but for some reason, it felt so real.
No, it's just kind of dark and the sky is pretty bright right now, so you either get the shadow or you get the subjects.
They can do one car wide shot now.
So when we fly, we have to take all this off.
We went to Asia for a month. For some reason, it's easier to remember the bad dreams, the nightmares. Focus on them so intensely that everything else feels false. They seem to cloud my mind when I wake up. Even though I forget parts of the nightmare, the main idea, the remnants of an unpleasant story still linger. But when I wake up from a good dream, I tend to forget nearly everything from it. I want to hold on to it. I want to remember it as much as I can. It's a good moment. The unrealistic smiles that find us dreaming again and again, longing for that piece of momentary happiness. Unless it's written down right away or said out loud, I always forget. For some reason, it always disappears. No pieces of anything aside from that brief feeling that's passed. No matter how much I want to hold on to it, cherish it, the feeling seems to vanish faster than I can enjoy it. But this dream, this happy yet sad dream, stuck with me. If I've loved so long, if I've never left your sight for the past month, why am I still dreaming of a time so elementary? Why am I so focused on a feeling we felt together 6 years ago?
Thank you.
If I knew everything about you, you would have never lived. It was our first time together for more than a week in a while. Life doesn't slow down in your 20s. No one ever said it did, but it feels as if it's supposed to. Our jobs could easily be remote, but the world doesn't work that way. Driven by this romanticized idea that constant work, striving for more, for better, to no end, is the end goal. But with you, right now, here in Japan, on these bike-filled streets, I don't feel guilty about doing nothing. I think that's what we really strive for, in the back of our minds. This nothing. And this nothing is where everything really happens, where our memories live. The ones we'll never forget. Sometimes it feels like we're living totally different lives. But if I knew everything about you, you would have never lived. I'm surrounded here by all these people, my community. Friends I never thought I'd have in a place that makes no sense to be at. A year ago, I would have never imagined I'd be in this circle, but somehow it feels so right. For the first time, I feel understood by a group of people, and we're in this crazy place. We have this castle all to ourselves in the French countryside. The food is great and the company's even better. An endless amount of laughs and conversations I've pent up my whole life. And despite all this, despite all these moments of happiness, all I can think about is you. This whole week I've been thinking about you subconsciously. Every waking hour, every conversation I've had with other people. In a lyric from the song that James Blake released the week this trip started, it's stuck in my head. How do I get to this place without you? How do you get to that place alone? How do I get to that place without you? How do you get to that place without me? Because when there's no one to throw at, I wish the world could know us like that. I've been feeling a sense of disconnection with you recently. With all the constant work and constant travel that we've both done, it feels like we're not able to share any of our experiences anymore. I know there's not a lot we can do. I know it's just this stage of our lives where nothing makes sense. Even though everything makes sense. Or time feels fleeting but whole in their own ways. Where we forget our problems but remember them together. Where our desires to chase our individual dreams begin to outweigh our collective ones. Where we fall back into our old habits but develop great new ones. Where we surround ourselves with other people, new friends, to make coming back to each other that much more impactful. Where we trust each other enough to know how important our individuality is. Where we believe in each other so much we forget to believe in ourselves. And as I laid on that bench next to Mont Saint-Michel, alone, staring at the sky, longing for a moment to reflect on the week, I listened to this song over and over again as the tears fell down my face.
Cut.
In the corner of my
is the way I truly am. In the backseat of my car, we're kissing poison and the arguments are melting like the sand, like the sand. And oh, how things change. I don't want to be with me anymore. And oh, it's such a shame to feel like I'm out of control. I'm out of control. Long for days with brighter skies, my dear. I'll make my way to paradise, don't fear for me. Cause I'm really, really trying to get better, to get better. Smiling so hard for me.
Dead?
No, next to each other.
Huh? Oh.
Maybe it's all meant to be, this lazy drunken agony that makes me want to stay in bed.
Like if you fell down, it wouldn't be that big of a deal.
It's all shadows and regrets, you know? The superficial cigarettes and all the stare makes me cry. And well, and oh, oh, how horrible it feels to be panicking. And oh, how unsolvable to feel like I'm out of control. So hug me tight and wish me luck, my friend, and hope that we will link arms again. Cause I'm really, really smiling to get better, to get better.
Walked up to the running stone. Running stone. Hey, walk, walk, walk. Running stone.
person in overseas. 可以吗？
可以。
可以哈，他说可以的。
谢谢。Hey, go, go.
Go?
Yeah.
我们哪？
Just the back.
我们就是那个啊，那他在我们等一下，这个就是后面。
So Don Don said he
said my dad also talked about his earrings.
What about my earrings?
Jacob, what now?
Number what?
Get off.
Wait, why do we need to remember?
This is where we go visit my mom and grandma's and dad's ashes. In the time of
First time meeting your extended family outside the two people that live in the US. We've known each other for around 10 years and been dating for 6 of those. You've met so much of my family, but I haven't really met any of yours. The awkward interactions, quiet tendencies, and curious smiles that you've had over the years meeting my family finally make sense to me. It's amazing how your mom's smile reflects the one I see on you every day, how she has this belief deep down inside of her thatShe still is here. I think her talkativeness and kindness are a good reflection of the people of Taiwan. Although I can't understand Mandarin or Taiwanese, I can feel it in their gestures, their smiles, the little things that make us all human. We went around the area your dad used to live at with your aunt who's never left. The sound of the mopeds feels comforting for some reason, even though I've never ridden one, and the streets remind me of that dream.We went to a temple where your ancestors were cremated. It was an hour and a half away in this beautiful place that overlooks the mountains. Weirdly enough, it was really peaceful to be in a place where so many lay rest. Told us how she had already bought a spot for her and your dad to sleep at and how it was still under development. For some reason, she was really excited about it. She made sure that Evie and I knew how to get to the temple to visit them in the future. She knows Google Maps exists, but for some reason, she wanted us to know without a map. We visited the night markets your parents used to go on dates at, and as we walked through, you'd stop at all the different stalls with your mom to grab a bite of the past.Everywhere. We visited these rocks. You helped me shoot part of an ad that never saw the light of day.
That's good. I need to just do a video. Oh shit!
Get it, get it.
Dang it.
Time you let yourself think. I might be gone every time I let myself blink. I wouldn't say I was surprised on the 82nd time. When's the last time your love was unrequited? I know I showed up to the party uninvited. It's getting hard for me to hide.
We often forget the presence of each other, not because we forget we're together, but because being together feels like we're experiencing life through the same eyes. Very few of these moments, these memories captured through a lens, show us together. As much as I'd like to, there's no real way to do it without feeling like we're acting. It's hard to ignore the presence of a rolling camera. It's almost easier to capture what we're seeing, how we're seeing it, than picturing us in the frame. From the hours and hours of footage I captured from this month-long trip, only about 1% of the footage shows us together. Those unrealistic moments that for some reason feel real looking back. It's hard to be fully present when I'm recording. It's hard to know when to stop. It's always been a dream of mine to be a cinematographer, a director, and it feels wrong to give up on that dream. But it also feels selfish to focus so deeply on that while on this trip with you. I tried to find the balance on this trip, but I don't think I was able to, and I'm sorry for that. But I will say that it's fitting that these moments that stick deeply in my memory are the uncaptured moments. The conversations with you and your family, that one clothing store we went to with the independent Taiwanese fashion designer struggling to make a name for himself at 50 years old, the bars your family didn't know existed with the drinks that were somehow better than any place we've been to in the US, the fluffy dog that our driver had and kept in the car after I told him I was allergic to dogs, the train rides across the island, the relaxation we felt from the bathhouses we went to, the silent competitions we had in those ice baths, seeing who could stay the longest. These moments that only make sense to us make the parts I filmed feel so much more disconnected in a way. But I think back to that dream again. The one where you said you loved me for the first time and am reminded how to love again.